Good morning everyone. Myself Dr. Trina Dattu, Assistant Professor, Chemistry Department, JIS College of Engineering. Today I am going to talk a very important topic, that is greenhouse effect and global warming. That is the part in Module 2, Air Pollution and Control, under effects of human health and climate. And if you have any doubt, you can contact in my mobile number. It is given here, and also the mail ID given here. So this one is the environmental science, the subject code MC301 for the odd semester and MC401 for the even semester. This course is for undergraduate BTech students. The streams are CSE, IT, Civil, Mechanical, Electrical, EC, and BME. This is the non-credited mandatory course, and the prerequisite knowledge required 11 and 12 standard. And I have created my own course page, my own website, that is given here. And also all the course material are uploaded in the blend space. So today's topic is effects on human health and climate, greenhouse effect and global warming. So the objective of this topic is to develop the concept of greenhouse effect, to develop idea about global warming, to learn the consequence of global warming, and two most important thing is to take initiative to control global warming. So first of all, I will define the greenhouse effect. So what is the old concept? As per old concept, in the colder region, we kept the warm house, that is the glass house, so sunlight can penetrate through the glass. Sunlight is the shorter wavelength, it can penetrate through the glass, but now the longer wavelength cannot go outside of this glass house. And what will happen, you can understand very easily. So inside the glass house, there will be a warm condition will be created, and as a result, plants can grow very easily. So this is the old concept of greenhouse effect. Now in the real life also, we can have the example, like say this is the car, and you can see the windshield, and the sun energy can passes through this windshield as it is the shorter wavelength, but this energy cannot go outside being the longer wavelength. So it will remain trapped inside this car. And also you have the practical experience that inside the car you feel warmer than the outside. So this is also example of greenhouse effect phenomena. Now, what actually we understand as greenhouse effect? So here, this is our earth, and this earth surface is covered by a blanket of atmosphere, and this contains different types of gases. This contains CO2, ozone, CFCs. There are lots of gases. And these gases can absorb the radiation which is coming from the sunlight. So in this way, the sunlight remains trapped in this blanket. So what actually happens? You can see here it is written, it is the shorter wavelength. So the solar radiation, you have to think two parts. One part is incoming solar radiation, another part is outgoing the earth radiation. So the incoming solar radiation, that is of shorter wavelength, so it can penetrate the atmosphere very easily. But after, at the daytime, so when the sunlight comes, the Earth's surface becomes hot. Now it becomes like a hot ball and it will radiate back. So when it will radiate back, the Earth radiation becomes the longer wavelength. So this longer wavelength cannot go outside of this atmosphere. So as a result, the Earth's surface becomes warmer. This phenomenon is called greenhouse effect. So I think you understood very clearly. So now, the greenhouse gases. So what are the greenhouse gases which can absorb the radiation, which can absorb the Earth radiation? So this greenhouse gases are carbon dioxide, CO2, water vapor, H2O, nitrous oxide, N2O, tropospheric ozone, O3, methane, CH4, and chlorofluorocarbon, CFC. So these six are greenhouse gases. They remain in different percentages, that means they contribute in different percentages of the trapping of the heat energy. So there are lots of gases in our atmosphere like O2, N2, but only these six are greenhouse gases, others are not. Now let's come to the point that how these greenhouse gases are generated. So I will tell few of them, like say CO2. So we get it from human respiration, from industrialization, burning of fossil fuel, burning of forest. Okay, so these are the sources of CO2. N2O, nitrous oxide. So nitrous oxide, that is also called the laughing gas, that comes from the vehicle exhaust, nitrogen-based fertilizer, etc. Methane. What is the formula of methane? That is the CH4. So we get it mainly from different waste, like it may be the cow dung. So mainly, or any leaves or any plants which are dead. So their anaerobic decomposition, we get the methane. CFCs. CFC we get from aerosol sprays, making foam packaging, coolant. It is used as coolant in fridge and air conditions. Okay, now it is, we have alternate. We are not using the CFC as in the air condition. Cleaning solvent. And this CFC has the capacity to trap heat. And they can remain atmosphere for long years. Okay, so you have learned very well what are the greenhouse gases. There are, I told you, there are only six greenhouse gases. So now the question arises that why all other gases are not greenhouse gases? Like say NO, it is not greenhouse gases, not NO, it is no. It is yes and this part is no. So these are the greenhouse gases, but these are not. Like O2 is not a greenhouse gas, NO, NO2, SO2, they are not greenhouse gas. N2 is not a greenhouse gas. So which will be greenhouse gas? So very simply to say, which can absorb the Earth radiation, they are the greenhouse gas. So I have told you, you have to think two part. One is incoming solar radiation, another is outgoing earth radiation. So outgoing earth radiation, it is the IR region, infrared region, and it remains in between 4 and 30 micrometer is frequency. So what happens when this frequency matches with the frequency of the molecules, then only they can absorb. Otherwise, I can say that which are IR active, they are the greenhouse gases. If the dipole moment is zero, then they are IR inactive. If the it has some dipole moment like CO2, O3 or CFCs, which are the greenhouse gases, they have the dipole moment. So they are IR active. That means they absorb the radiation in the frequency range of 4 micrometer to 30 micrometer. As for example, like CO2 absorb the 15 micrometer radiation. So it is in the range of 4 to 30 micrometer, but O2, NO2, they are IR inactive as their dipole moment is zero. So you have understood very well that which gases are, why all the gases are not greenhouse gases. Now the question is that I'm telling that greenhouse effect is very harmful. So is it so, or it is required? Okay, let's see. So it is two cases, I have taken two cases. One is Mars, another is Venus. So in the Mars, the atmosphere is negligible. So greenhouse effect is barely apparent and surface temperature is 218 Kelvin or minus 55 degrees centigrade. So you can understand that if the greenhouse effect is absent, then also life does not exist. That is why in the Mars, the temperature is too low, life cannot exist. Now, let's take Venus. So here the opposite condition, reverse condition. Atmospheric pressure is 100 times than Earth. CO2 concentration here 97%. So the greenhouse effect is very pronounced and surface temperature is 750 Kelvin or 477 degrees centigrade. And so the people or life does not exist in Venus. So our main concern is now the temperature is increasing. Temperature is required at a certain limit, otherwise we cannot exist. But if it is too high, then also we cannot exist. So now, due to the greenhouse gases, the temperature of the Earth surface is increasing, and that is our main concern. Okay, let's do one assignment. That is MCQ, very easy one. Okay, tell me, which of the following is a greenhouse gas? So you have learned there are 6 greenhouse gases. So O3, SO2, NO2, CO. So it is very easy. You can answer that O3 will be the greenhouse gas. Next is, which of the following is not a greenhouse gas? O3, CO2, NO2, H2 vapor. So the answer will be NO2. NO2, you can remember that NO2 is a criteria pollutant, but it is not a greenhouse gas. The short answer type question. Define greenhouse effect. So you can answer you will say that the solar radiation, being the shorter wavelength, can penetrate the earth's the blanket of atmosphere surrounding the earth's surface, but the outgoing earth radiation, being the longer radiation, cannot go outside. So do you know that what is the range of this radiation? So the solar radiation, it is 0.5 micrometer, and outgoing earth radiation, that is 10.1 micrometer. Mention 6 greenhouse gases. So 6 greenhouse gases, you can tell that CO2, CH4, N2O, nitrous oxide, ozone, H2O vapor, and CFC. Explain why all the gases are not greenhouse gases. So you have learned these things, that the gases which are IR active, which can absorb the earth radiation, they are only the greenhouse gases. O2, N2, they are not the greenhouse gases. So why people cannot exist in Mars and Venus? So there is the temperature, the tremendous, that means one part there is too low temperature in Mars, another part too high temperature in the Venus. So life does not exist in both the cases. So greenhouse effect is required, but at a certain limit. Okay, next is global warming. So what is global warming? So this is the gradual increase of temperature of the earth atmosphere, that is called global warming. So due to the greenhouse effect, the earth temperature is increasing day by day. So it is given year wise data. So how the temperature of the earth surface is increasing? So actually we can say the global warming is the consequence of greenhouse effect. So greenhouse effect is the reason and global warming is the result. How global warming works? So here you can understand that there are lots of greenhouse gases. They will absorb the heat energy, and as a result, temperature increases. That is a thermometer. So temperature will be increased. So in this way, our earth surface becomes warmer. So what are the causes? What are the causes of global warming? Or we can say, what are the causes of greenhouse effect? The similar. So pollution from coal, natural gas, etc. CO2 from airplane, vehicles, increased population, deforestation. So there are lots of causes of global warming. So what are the consequences? Consequence is the increased temperature of the earth surface. What are the other consequences, like melting of glaciers? This is the scenario. We can see the before Antarctica was that. Now the Antarctica is this one. This is the Alaska in 1914-2004. Arizona, Colorado River, you can see it is drying. Another consequence, the polar bear extinction. This is the melting polar ice caps. So if the temperature increases, the polar ice will melt. This is the another consequence, warmer waters and more hurricanes. That means the extreme weather events are increasing. So extreme weather condition, you can see the drop in one place, another place there is flood. The consequence of global warming, that is the climate change. So our climate is changing and now it is unpredictable. So there are different extreme climate events like cyclone, hurricanes. So this is very difficult to take measures of all these situations. Increase the probabilities and heat waves. It is the probability increases of drought and increases the heat waves. And if the heat waves increases, the plants will be dead. So if we summarize, then global warming and their effects, we can understand. So what is global warming? So it is the gradual increment of temperature of the Earth's surface. So the average global temperature has increased almost 1 degree Fahrenheit over the past century. And what are the effects? So sea level rises, warmer the weather, so glacier will melt, melting glacier. So not only that, the crops, and there will be the effects in crop and food supply, and there will be other effects like climate change. The photosynthesis will be retarded, and if the photosynthesis will be retarded, then there will be effect in the fruit production and crops production. So the food, crops, all these things will be destroyed. Now, how we can stop global warming? That is the most important part. How we can stop global warming? We understood what is global warming, what are the causes of global warming, sources of global warming. Now, somehow we have to protect our environment and we have to stop the global warming. So most important part is spread awareness. If we do together, then only we can win. So we must turn off our computer or TV when we are not using it. We can use the efficient bulb which requires less energy, because we know that the power also comes from the carbon based or fossil fuel based energy. So we have to reduce the use of AC. We can use the light clothes in the summer. We can unplug the unused electronics. We can use bicycle when we are going nearby. We can use the bus instead of our private car. We can recycle all the materials, because as much as the waste material will be increased, the after burning or their disposal, due to their disposal, then the greenhouse gases will be created. So our main motto is to reduce greenhouse gases. plant trees, that is the most common. If there is no place for tree plantation, then we can do the vertical farming. Not only that, we can use the alternate energy sources which are not based on fossil fuel. Mainly from the fossil fuel we get the greenhouse gases like CO2. Because the fossil fuel like petrol, diesel, coal, wood, all these are carbon based. So from there, after the burning, we get CO2 and H2O vapor. Both of them are greenhouse gases. So we can use the alternate energy resources like solar power, like wind power, and also we can innovate fuel efficient cars. We can use the fuel efficient cars, so less amount of fuels will be used. And this is the Kyoto Protocol. This is a treaty where all the countries came together and they told that they will reduce the greenhouse gas emission. And this is effective from December 2012. So all these are solutions. Already I have told one by one, that is the summary. So different parts we can do to reduce the creation of greenhouse gases. So somehow we have to remove the cause. So global warming basically caused by greenhouse effect. So if we can reduce the amount of greenhouse gases or production of greenhouse gases, or if we can recycle them, then we can reduce the global warming. So now the short answer time question, that is the assignment 3. Define greenhouse effect. What are the consequences of global warming? How it can be controlled? Mention 6 greenhouse gases. Why all gases are not greenhouse gases? And what is Kyoto Protocol? So all these things you can answer very easily. So what you have learned today, I like to summarize. So first you have learned greenhouse effect and greenhouse gases. Also, you have learned the sources of greenhouse gases. Then you global warming and their consequences. Importance of greenhouse effect. That means greenhouse effect is also required, but at a certain limit. Control of global warming. So this part we have learned today. In this lecture, you have learned all this part. So this is the assignment. Define greenhouse effect. What are the consequences of global warming? So you will write this assignment in a Word document or PowerPoint. Then you have to create a lesson. Then upload it and share with my code. So these are the reference book. You can take the support and the study material also uploaded in my course. You can read from there anytime, anywhere. Thank you, students.